He's one of our greatest comedians, and now John Clarke's entire collection is available at New Zealand On Screen for fans old and new.
As Rhys Mathewson reports, if it weren't for John Clarke and the wonderful Fred Dagg, where would we be?
Righto, kick it in the guts, Trev.
John Clarke, the man who changed the face of New Zealand comedy.
I think I might go into town today. So I want the number plate taken off the tractor, put on the Land Rover.
On Tuesday night at Te Papa, old colleagues, friends and fans celebrated the launch of a legendary back catalogue.
He changed everything for us. He was a guy that gave us the confidence to be New Zealand comedians. He's the beginning.
And his impact is still felt today. For satirist Tom Sainsbury, hosting the event was a privilege.
I'm 100% John Clarke fan. What I kind of loved about like Fred Dagg and Wolf Footrot was that they were kind of like my dad's friends. Like I was seeing my dad, who's a farmer, and his mates kind of represented on screen, which I thought was really funny.
Now Kiwis of all ages can relive the moments of magic he brought to our screens.
This would be the basic world. Anything that's in the world would be in here, and anything that's not here you can pretty safely assume it's got nothing to do with the world at all.
One of the most interesting things that's happened in Timaru for a couple of decades now, this particular piece of film.
The event was also a chance for friends of John Clarke to reminisce.
I was asked to update John's New Zealand Arts All Black 15, which is terrific, and I spent hours getting John's face right.
What do you think of the hallmarks of John Clarke's comedy?
Dryness, he was droll, he didn't try too hard. John did Royal Weddings as a Peter Kelly racing commentary. Princess Anne and Captain Mark Phillips going down the aisle now. You know, Princess Anne by her nose, I wouldn't want to pick that.
He was a good example for how to live a life really well and make the most of it.
Oh, well, you shouldn't have.
I haven't. Best guy on the coast.
If John Clarke were here tonight, what would he think of an event like this?
He'd be poo-pooing it.
He would probably say it's not an entirely unsatisfactory result.
Eventually, John buggered off to Australia and found more success with The Current Affair.
Well, I'm not saying it wasn't safe, it's just perhaps not quite as safe as some of the other ones.
Why?
Well, some of them are built so the front doesn't fall off at all.
Well, wasn't this built so the front wouldn't fall off?
Well, obviously not.
How do you know?
Well, because the front fell off.
But it's not the first time Fred Dagg's been at the museum. In 2002, John asked Te Papa to bring his iconic outfit home.
I was sent to Melbourne to meet him, and then he handed the outfit to me.
Did you have to wash it when it arrived?
No, we didn't. Though I did have to wash the gumboots, but that was for customs, because John Clarke had recently mown the lawns wearing his gumboots, and I got them back to the hotel, and I realised with a panic that I couldn't hand them over with grass and dirt on them.
So he was still wearing them out and about, just day to day?
They were in the back of his car.
But this look back at his legacy was, for some, bittersweet.
It's very hard to talk about him in the abstract. All I know is we miss him, and I'm sure New Zealand misses him.